This is probably one of the most important videos I'm going to release this year. MzeroA Nation, this is Jason. By the way, turning stalls. Maybe if this was you, let me know in the comments below, and I do read every comment. The first time I ever did turning stalls was on my private pilot check ride. I already had a fear of stalling. I had never done a turning stall, never heard of a turning stall in my life, thank goodness. I had a very, very understanding and forgiving check ride examiner. And we kind of worked through some turning stalls, and I was very lucky and thankful to pass. I don't want you to be in the same situation I was on my private pilot check ride, going, hey, give me a power on turning stall. A what? In a Cherokee 140, no less. It was a little bit intimidating. So I want to show you them here first. I've done my clearing turns. Life is looking good. Everything is set. Let's do a power on, because that'll end up being the most aggressive turning stall, and I'm going to work you through it here. Now, remember, examiners, CFIs, we don't care how you get into the stall, right? It's all about the recovery. We practice stalls to practice recoveries, not to practice how to get into a stall. But I still want to make this as realistic as possible. So what am I simulating in a power-on turning stall? I'm simulating I just took off, and maybe ATC says, hey, I need an immediate left turn, an immediate right turn, whatever that may be. So I'm going to slow the airplane on down. I'm going to keep it clean because we're going to do it power-on, like a takeoff stall, essentially, departure stall, sometimes they're called. Power-on stall is the proper verbiage, though. I'm going to slow us down to our rotation speed because I want to make this as realistic as possible. So I'm passing through 75 right now. I'm applying a little bit of back pressure. I have to. It's a little strong, a little heavy. But I've got that, and I could use trim right now to help me, but it's not. I'm going to be taking it right back out again here in a second. Okay, I rotate about 65, so there's carb heat, and I'm going to go full power. And you don't have to go full power to start. You could baby your way into this with, like, you know, 2,000 RPMs. All right, I'm taking off, and all of a sudden ATC says, 2-3 Mike Zulu, make an immediate right turn for traffic. So I'm pitching up. I'm really not paying attention. I'm making a right-hand turn, up, 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 up. And all of a sudden, push forward, opposite pedal, brake the stall, and you're basically on the brink of a spin, is why that can be so intimidating a little bit. You felt it break, you saw the nose coming down, and I had to actually push more forward to initiate that recovery. And I just stepped opposite my turn. Let's do another one in the opposite direction here. Let me get myself back to cruise first. All right, carb heat. Bring just some power on back. Let me tell you what I'm bringing it back to. About 1,600, 1,700 RPMs, like a run-up RPM. For me, I'm getting stronger and stronger. I don't want to lose altitude, right? I can't be losing altitude right now. I'm holding my north heading. Here comes 65. Carb heat comes in. Full power. You don't have to do full power right off the bat. It makes you nervous. We're climbing out ATC. 2-3 Mike Zulu. Immediate left-hand turn. Okay, we're going to the left, going left. Up, 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 up. Here it comes. Here it comes. It wants to break right. Push forward. A little bit of left pedal. And get this airplane flying. Again here. Turning stalls don't have to be intimidating if you've done them before and you know what you're setting up for as well. I would encourage you, with your CFI, please, to go practice some turning stalls. You can also do them in the power off environment. They're not nearly as bad in the power off environment, but you could go practice them in the power off environment as well. Turning stalls. Who has practiced turning stalls? Let me know in the comments below. They are just vitally important. MzeroA Nation, by the way, you know all about our new online ground school. There are 50 hours of new courses, new private, new instrument, new remote pilot, new initial and recurrent remote pilot, new private pilot bootcamp, new instrument pilot bootcamp. You've heard the whole spiel about everything. Our new learning management system, proprietary to us as well. MzeroA RSVP. We get on an RSVP list to get in first with the new online ground school. I just can't wait to showcase that to you all. Thank you for being a blessing to ourselves. You are a part of this MzeroA Nation, this MzeroA family. I know we're in some crazy times right now, and in crazy times, and good times and bad times, family takes care of family. And you are truly a part of our family. So if there's anything we can do to help you in this time, please, 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 don't hesitate to reach out. You have a team at MzeroA.com that is just so dedicated to helping you and just making you that safer, smarter pilot. So let us know in the comments below. Send us a support ticket. Call the studio, whatever you need. Have a wonderful rest of your day. And most importantly, remember that a good pilot is always learning. Have a great day, everyone. We'll see you.